Okay. Well, hey, with Unreal, it's really easy to make maps. I'll definitely be putting out some tutorials and things like that as well. It'll help you place things, help you know how to optimize things, and just, you know, some inspiration and stuff like that too. Excuse me. I'm just gonna clean up this cliff face before I have a really cool idea for something I want to do in this area right here. I was doing some research, aka looking at Google Images, and I found a really cool rock formation in I don't remember exactly what forest, but a rock formation in a forest, and I have a feeling I could do something pretty cool with that idea. So it's gonna take a little bit of flattening, and I always have to pay attention to scale. It's really important too. So, you know, like, this is human height. So if we flatten this area in general, yeah, I think that could work. Maybe a little bigger to account for the rocks. Yeah, something like that. Alright. I'm gonna double check that I'm working on the right tile, actually. Right on the edge of it. That'll be fine. It doesn't have to be exact. So let's grab some of these cliff face meshes. It's gonna be like kind of like a multi-layer in different ways. But we'll get there eventually. Give it a little bit of variation. And the, oh, thank you for subscribing! Much appreciated. Let's grab a different mesh. And In fact, I think I'll just swap some of these around. It can start getting really monotonous. Humans are really good at detecting patterns. So in this case, it's best to kind of, you know, swap it around a little bit. But basically what I'm going to do is I'm creating a... imagine like a rocky overhang. And there's a hole right in the center where light can shine through. So you'll end up with kind of some trees growing in the center here. Because light can actually reach the ground there. And then, you know, just kind of like an open den. If that makes any sense. Well, I'll show you what it looks like once I get this placed and everything. It'll be pretty cool, I think. But this will be big enough so that the larger dinosaurs can fit in it without too many problems. I think I might need to flatten that a little bit. That should be fine. And I definitely want it to be two ways in and two ways out, kind of thing. Just so that you don't get cornered in it. So, you know, it's kind of people will come and go through it as opposed to people will hole up in it like a fortress. I mean, maybe they might too, but there's not really too much in the game that would really require you to camp an area. So people probably won't camp something like this. Is a little bit better. I think this is the rock without the bottom. Yep, alright. Just have to be careful with how I use this one. Because it's easy to accidentally keep it clipping. I think what I might do... Where's the one rock that has the actual overhang? Oops. It's this one. So you can kind of see what I'm going to be going for here. One cool thing is if you need to flip an asset, you just scale it in the opposite dimension. Plug that up. Hope to see how well this works out. This is what I really want. This nice curve. Probably pull these guys in just a little bit more. Can always block up any overhangs. I mean, you know, any transparent areas. Yeah, like that. I'll have to do some polish later. Excuse me. Excuse me. You didn't hear it from me, but I actually have plans to do termite hills. We have like prehistoric ants that we've painted. Like they probably don't look that much different from real like modern day ants, but we got some ants, and I'll be doing like some termite mounds. I'm not sure whether or not I want to let the Struthiomimus eat from them. This might be kind of cool, but I'll have to see. I'm not really sure if it was actually like an insectivore, but you know, we've got leather speculation in this game, so why not put something kind of cool like that in? So I wonder if because this isn't going to be accessible from the top, I might be able to just see how that looks without it feeling like it's too jagged. You know, I think that works. Matt, what are you doing watching the stream anyways? Why don't you just come over in here? You're in the other room. No, growth isn't planned for launch. But it'd be really cool to add that in the future, I think. But we'll have to see how it goes. Thank you. Yeah, I mean, the game's about doing quests, and I mean, it's an MMO, right? So you'll be doing quests, you'll be unlocking new abilities. You won't necessarily level up, as in, like, woohoo, you're level 15 or something like that, but you'll be unlocking new attacks and abilities that might be considered, you know, I am now slightly more powerful. Or, you know, different, at least. Yeah, it's more like you specialize into different things. Oh, you know what? I like this. I think I'll clean that up and leave that. That's kind of cute. But yeah, you specialize into, you know, maybe you want slightly faster but perhaps less powerful attacks, or you want some bigger, bulkier attacks, you want different kinds of attacks, you want to improve your senses in different ways. Maybe you get, faster. But as a trade-off, you have less stamina, stuff like that. Just lets you dictate how you want to play, as opposed to having to purely stick with the archetype that you choose. I mean, that the dinosaur is optimized to play with to begin. I mean, we don't really want to rip off limbs in any way. Like, if your leg gets ripped off, then how are you supposed to interact with that limb? Like, as a game mechanic, there might be a limb mechanic that, you know, you have to interact with something in some way. And also, it makes locomotion really difficult to figure out if all of a sudden you don't have a leg. But, for something like the Despleto, I think it would mostly just be you would actually get scars on your body. And for most carnivores, is more just going to be, you're going to have scars on your body. But certain dinosaurs like a Stego or Styraco with his horns, those could actually be ripped off because they're... I mean, I'm sure they're kind of there for defense in some way, but mostly they're cosmetic in terms of their usefulness. Well, this is looking pretty good. Yeah, something like that. I'll have to go and retexture all the rocks. Let's fill in the holes. This one might be a little finicky. I think what I'll probably do is just put this up like here. And I think what I'll probably do is actually pull the mountain up. Doesn't have to look perfect just because I'll be Yeah, I'll do the flat tool. I'll just add some cliffs around the edge of this. You know, it's not very accessible, the top. So I'll do that in a sec. Let's get this looking how we want it, though. Alright, this part right here needs the arch. I think I'll need the flattened tool for this. Needs to be I'll smooth that out, but that'll look a bit like that. And I will put, kind of needs to look like it's part of the landscape. So if I pull this around, thank you. bit of this around too. And then I'll layer it up. That's a bit much. They're a bit of a pain, but it doesn't take too long to fill them up, so to speak. And then I'll put one that's up here, but it's more vertical. Because it doesn't, you know, it's not a perfect circle. That makes it a bit more interesting. I'll just fill out this hole. I mean, I suppose that's not so bad. I kind of want to fill that one up, though. And that one, of course, but I'll get there. Let me think for a second. Yeah, that won't work. Cool idea, though. Yeah, I'll fill this in. perimeter. Needs to be these guys. Specifically, yeah, I mean, that's big enough. No, nothing can jump up that.
Thank you.
I don't think that'll work. Oops. I think I can get that to work. And then it's just a matter of sculpting the terrain up behind it. And then putting a drop. We're getting there. So you'll come around and you'll just see this cliff face. And it'll look fine. And I'll put in a secret little tunnel going in here. And then you'll come around and once I clean this up a little more, you'll end up with the hole itself here, and then you'll be down here, and you won't be able to get up. You might be able to cheese your way up some of these areas, but probably not. And it kind of looks all cohesive. And then I'll just put a couple big rocks here, jutting out straight up. So it's more of just an off-limits area, but that's okay. Excuse me. Excuse me. Thank you. I mean, I wonder if I could make this area walkable still. I mean, clearly not the top up here. That's just gonna be a nightmare. But might be able to do like up here, kind of. Oh, that's a bit much. It's still a bit much. What I think I'll have to do is smooth this area out a little. When you're making maps, you have to be careful because the steepness of the terrain is really important. Nobody likes playing on terrain that's like 45 degree angle slope. Like, it's just, it's not fun. Like, imagine playing on this. I mean, you know, the terrain alignment and the IK will work fine, but you're either staring, when you have your screen level, you're either staring off, you know, either into the distance or, you know, trees right there, or you're staring flat at the ground, and you have to kind of angle your camera up or down. It's not very fun, in my opinion, and from what I've seen. You know, combat's difficult because someone's always got the high ground. Certainly there's places for it, but if most of your map is at such a steep angle, it's just never quite feels as immersive as it should be. I mean, because in nature, in the real life, most terrain has what's called a natural angle of repose, or at least most ground types. So if you've got gravel and you were to pour it in a pile, it has a certain angle that it all settle down into, in like a cone shape. And you know, if you're standing on rocks and they're at a 45 degree angle, I mean, fine, that works, but generally your soil wouldn't really ever be at a 45 degree angle or steeper. I mean, it all depends on the ground type, of course, but... And even if a player doesn't necessarily know why it feels off, because they might not understand or might not be aware of something like the natural angle of repose, for example, it still contributes to the off feeling that something really steep like that would have. But, you know. I mean, sometimes it can be intentional, and I mean, that can be fine as well, but in my opinion, I try and avoid that. So, you know, I see something like this, and I don't... I mean, it's not so bad if it's just this very small area, but I generally want everything to try and stay level, and then actually have it more like a tier or a plateau, like this. So instead of trying to force this to be a 45 degree angle slope, just go ahead and make it a cliff. It looks more interesting, and it gives but like more interesting gameplay ideas. You know, someone can stand up there and taunt someone down there, vice versa maybe. Oh, well, that's not good. Yeah, that's my opinion, and that's why most of this map here is it needs to be vertical, mind you. Like, vertical maps are fun and great. There's a lot of verticality to this map. But it's not like gigantic slopes. Although part of it is also making sure you get your values and things set correctly in World Machine, which is our DEM creation tool. I mean, you can use other tools like Gaia, but we were using World Machine and Valtiel, who made this map, or at least the height map for this map. He did a really good job at keeping everything to scale. Like, one thing that I really like about this map is all of these gullies and things that you see, they're all perfectly made so that they're about dinosaur size to fit through. Probably would be a little more obvious in some of the other areas. Like here, for example. If you were to fly through this, or sorry, walk through this, like, most of these gullies and things are about the correct size for a dinosaur to walk through. Which is just this nice little bonus where if someone's trying to walk up a cliff like this, and they decide to go off the beaten trail and go straight up here, they'll very likely be able to find a way to get up, and it's not frustrating for them anymore. You know, not always, but most instances, there's always a way to get up. You know? You can see that? But, yeah. So, let's finish this piece here. That looks okay. When you're in here... Yeah, I'll just take a couple of these boys and make them big. And let some trees grow on top as well. Excuse me. Excuse me. Have this looming over a little bit, so it kind of feels like it's part of it. Yeah, it's a bit repetitive. One sec. Whoop. It's not so bad. Interesting. And let's do... I'll pull this up, actually. It's worthwhile doing. Oops. Okay. Yeah, it needs a little more verticality to it, which, in my opinion, means more rocks. But placed carefully, so they kind of tilt downwards. Make sure it doesn't go through the roof. Yeah, that did. What if this one was a little taller? Because it's not so bad. So you kind of like simulate it, make it feel a lot bigger and more imposing than it might actually be by just layering things nicely. And I'm actually gonna put a little bit of interest where there's like two layers here, or it looks like there's two layers here, a little wider. Let's fill that. I think that just makes it look a little more solid. All right, cool. Just want to increase the thickness of some of these. Seems a little too thin at times. What's this? Okay, cool. That looks pretty good. Actually, I think I want to block this. I'll just use one of the flat rocks. Let me sink this down just a little more, because it is possible to look into that. Oh, bit much. And then we can layer this up a little. up. Actually, that's a bit too obvious. Let's layer this one up. That area looks a little ugly. Oops. Cool. It's Danger Mountain. Let's just get this side done too. Get this down.
Thank you.
Excuse me. with just a little cleanup, I think this will be ready to go. We can test it out. Yeah. There. Let's just smooth it out a bit. Let's see what it looks like with foliage. Bah. I'll have to regenerate a lot of this. Let's see what we can do. Be mostly just the trees. Excuse me. One down. Two down. The conifer trees. I wonder if any of them will stay in the center. That would be really cool if a couple did. Oh yeah, a couple did. Awesome. Don't even have to put anything down. So you kind of just get this big rocky area. Then you run in, and there's bushes and trees and... Cool. Oh, I should put water in the middle. It'll be perfect. I still have to do the cliffs on this area though. But... I mean, yeah, it feels pretty good. Would like more trees up here. That's right. Let's test it. Let's do the raptor, because it's the smallest one. That's what it has to look good for. Let me save first. Alright, let's go. So this is a little large, but we want big dinos to be able to go through it, so that's okay. It's good that the fog works in here. some rocks down in here too and paint the foliage a bit better. Oh, I'll have to fix that. Resimulate the bushes because that's a little silly. Let me do that right now, actually. Let's see how it looks. Still bushes by the front and in here a bit. That's alright though. Kind of makes it more mysterious. Cool. Yeah, I think it needs a couple just like small rocks in here. Grab these. That'll look really good. Oops. Awesome. Okay. That works enough, I think. To the next area. I spent a long time on that one. Okay, just turn off the foliage for now, just so I can see a bit better. Let's get rid of the bird. Actually, I'll leave him there for now. Let's do... this little cliff face here. These easy enough. Where's my flatten tool? Down. Let's paint it real quick. Yep. Let's grab these guys too. This is looking a little drab. Duplicate everything. I definitely want to put more of these. They just really add so much detail for basically doing nothing, you know? Just gotta make sure not to overdo it at times, but rotate things and no one will know. Except for you guys, because you watched me make it. Because what I've done here is the these clovers on top of the rocks here actually blend seamlessly with the clovers that you can paint on the ground. So you can't even really tell where it starts and ends. I mean, apart from the foliage that doesn't grow on top, but that's alright. I can't imagine it would really grow on top. But maybe I could add some. Might be kind of fun. But yeah, see, look at that. Huh. This looks really good. But the Titans is coming out at the end of 2019. That's the targeted release date, at least. I want to emphasize this is a rocky area. That's this area with the cave. So let's pull this around. What am I looking for? Oh, right, paintbrush. Took me a second. Ooh. Oh, yo. Needs a little something. I guess I haven't put down any of the actual smaller rocks recently. Let me go grab a few. These guys. these guys break up a lot, I find. May put another one of these guys somewhere. Oh. I wonder how corny that would look. One sec. Wonder how big they can make this get away with it. Can I have a tunnel through a fallen log? Oh, that'd be really cool. To make sure you don't scale it up too big, though. Oh, where's the bird? Actually, I can probably just hit play and then take control of the bird. And find the path. I'm sure there'll be some trees clipping through it though. Is that it? Oh, it works pretty well. I like it. It's pretty cool. I guess that doesn't work out too well. I wonder why no trees spawned here. Whoa. Did a redwood tree really spawn right there? Might remove that one. Looks a little silly. Alright, that looks like it worked out pretty well. Yeah, the small guys definitely have a lot of log tunnels in general. Maybe not so much out here on the more open forest, but up here where there's the more of the gullies and things, there's a lot more of them. Interesting. What I probably should do is actually create a path that leads people down here. Maybe branches off right here. I mean, that makes sense for there to be a path like that. Excuse let's flatten it out a little bit too. One thing that's really, really important for paths, making them feel like they're believable, is for them actually to be flat. Like that. It's really subtle. But if you flatten it, and actually make it look like it's been used to an extent. There. Wow. Like, that's not good. No one would walk on a path like that. And then you can just smooth it out a little bit too. Flat. Wow. I think everything else is pretty flat. I kind of want to make a trail that leads to those caves here. Yeah, maybe like, you know what? This will be a crossroads. That'll be perfect. That's a little bit. Figure out a way down. That's probably a good way. Subtle, but enough. All it takes is a little dirt trail to pull people in. And yeah, they're kind of like game trails or just trails to lead people to more interesting points of interest. Because if there's no trails, which is fine to an extent, but if there's no trails, then if there's something really cool that you want to guide players to, they might not ever find it. Like this area has some water and a cave and just some interesting things, but if you're at the other points of interest over here and over here, you know, you might not ever bother going there. Not everything will have a trail, because some things should just be discovered on their own. Because that feels really rewarding for players to discover some really unique hidden cave or, you know, hidden things. Like, this area right here is not going to have anything leading you to it. But in here is actually a small burrow or den or something like that. And that's going to remain as it is. Alright, this area feels pretty populated with stuff. Still gotta go in and fix this lake. It's not looking too hot. Let's do that now, actually, because it's really important. Yeah, I wanted a river going through here. Is this actually flat? It goes uphill a little bit. Quite big. I don't know how I feel about that. Okay, well, let's get this cleaned up. It's gotta do a lot of work. Let's see. So these are really, really big, and they don't look very natural. So let's scale them down a little, and actually have a second tier to them. Maybe a little more vertical. I wonder if I could. No, I think they're too steep for that. To put the other cliff faces that we have. It doesn't have to be everywhere, it just has to be enough so that it feels like it's properly in scale now. Probably just turn this actually. Because, you know, that's not really natural looking right there, unfortunately. Come on. Give me that. That's a bit better. And this just needs to be a lot more shallow. General, like your lakes, they don't very rarely do they actually just start without actually having a pretty decently sized riverbank. So let's just flatten everything out. Oh, the river. Oh, I don't want to touch the river. I have to delete the whole thing, basically. And all these volumes, too. Oh, I'll get to it later. Alright, that looks a bit better. Now this is much too steep still though. The river? Make the river longer? Just because, like, water doesn't flow naturally that steep, you know? So this river is just completely unnatural. It needs to be completely deleted, pretty much. And turned into more like small waterfalls. It's like small waterfall steps, kind of like this. But, yeah, it's just, it's not right. But But that'll be like going in and making it a spline and doing all that stuff. So I'll have to do that later. Right, so we probably want to have more rocks hanging out in here. Rapids, yes. They can be that steep to an extent, but you wouldn't have rapids just in this very tiny area then flowing into a very small lake. Like, rapids are the culmination of many, many rivers coming into one area. You know? Like, we have this tiny meandering river, and then it just turns straight into a rapids and flows straight downhill into this very small lake. It doesn't work out too well. Especially if we're in a redwood biome or something like that. It doesn't necessarily happen, and the soil doesn't lend itself to that. Let's see. I need to get this. Well, I'll just hide that tile for now. It's really not good to have these kinds of volumes on slants. It's really not good. Is this it? Yeah, that's it. Crazy. All right, let's grab some more rocks. Excuse me. Oh, this is interesting. Oh, I can go with that. This is so big. Kind of a cool overhang. Could do a cave in it. Let's do the cave end cap. Hello. Not on this map yet, but definitely something planned. let's just put some rocks down here. Let's get these painted as well. Excuse me. Thank you. to make sure there's actually mud painted underneath. To do is around the edges, right where mud meets or water meets earth, you can kind of, let's paint mud back in here actually, but you can grab the dirt and give it kind of a rough edge like this. Makes it look a little bit better, almost like there's a shore. Because otherwise it's just kind of, it's not defined. I'd kind of like there to be a rocky beach. And I can kind of put some debris too. Like a fallen log in here maybe? Might look kind of good. Like a driftwood, almost. I mean, obviously not, but you know. almost like it was starting to grow, and then the water kind of encroached on it, and it fell into the water. A long time ago, that is. And there's some... this one, too. I don't know, just interest. Let's see what it looks like with the foliage turned on. Oh, that's not good. Hope this looks a lot better after the regenerate. So regenerate the conifer bushes. Let's give that a second. Oh, boy. I wonder if I could have any, like, floating logs. That might be really cool. I wonder if I could pull that off. I mean, it might not look perfect, so just kind of be hanging. But, you know, let's see. I still want there to be trees, like, right up to the edge. Also, what? Is there actually plants in here? I mean, it's mud, right? No, that's foliage. Is it trying to spawn on the plane? Okay, that fixed it. Like some trees generated in here too, which, you know, might be okay. Bop. Yeah, I think that's okay. It's kind of interesting. I would like for there to be more in here though. What are you doing in there? Excuse me. Not a huge fan of this area. tilt it down a little, and then I'll just flatten it. Flatten everything.
Oops.
That feels a lot better. You can actually walk through it properly and not feel like you're falling off a cliff. This is a really interesting area. I could do a lot of cool stuff in here if I wanted to. Well, I do want to. Could almost do like tiered gullies. I think that would look really good. But let's get this area done first. I'm gonna flatten and paint this area slightly so we can actually have some foliage coming in here, hopefully, because the trees only like spawning on flat areas. I'll have to see how well it works out. Otherwise I'll just hand place a few. Smooth it out a little bit so it's not terribly steep in any one given area. It's not so bad. Actually, that's really steep. Let's at least make it look like it's steep for a purpose, like maybe it's extra rocky. Let's bring some more of these in here. So they kind of like, create the rocky edges. Maybe a little higher. And let's just flatten this out a little bit. Just so you don't feel like you're trying to walk up a slope that's too steep for its own good. It's a little better. Alright, let's see if our foliage actually generates or not. Gotta assign a hotkey to that. Trees. Ah, shoot. Didn't work. What I might need is just to paint some more needles down there. So I think the majority of them actually spawn on the needles, too. Let's try that. Got a couple. Into the small trees, and hopefully that'll fill it in. Better than nothing. Don't know how well this will work out, but I really want to do like the lily pad stuff. This might take a little bit, but let's try it. So there's these lily pads here. And I suppose I could hand place them, but would be really cool to have the procedural foliage spawning volume work on that. So let's see. We got these. kind of regret double clicking on that. Let's see how long this takes to load. Oh. Yeah, that's not exactly what I'm looking for. I'll make my own. Okay, let's see how well this works out. Let's just do this whole lake first. Let's see how well it works out. So, we want it to only be placed on static meshes. So it'd be only this lake, and what's the density of it? Well, let's try it. Oh. What if I place a plane down here? Will it spawn on those? Well, but if I delete the plane, it also deletes those. I suppose that fixes it. Might be better if I hand paint these. Or, I mean, I suppose I could just remove them. Just around the edge. Doesn't look half bad. the bird. Yeah, that's not gonna work. I don't think I can use the plane. Alright, that works. Let's put the swimming water. A little too high.
Thank you.
I really want to see if a floating log would work. Well, I'll leave it in there for now. It's not the end of the world if it doesn't work out. I want to do more swamps. I think that might be fun. This area down here might be perfect for a swamp. It's kind of like a lowlands. And they could drain out. Well, I'll do that next time because that's going to be a big project. Let's finish up this area here. Excuse me. It's gonna do kind of like a raised area here. Thank you. Okay, after I finish this little raised area, I'm definitely gonna pop off. I think that's plenty done for tonight. Get that committed, get in the build, have people playtest it, tell me what they think, and hopefully find bugs. Because I'm sure I've forgotten many, many things. Alright. Awesome. I kind of want to put something in the middle. Oh! I got an idea. Make it a little more interesting. We'll grab one of these guys. I love these so much. I'm so glad I built this little piece. Whoop. I'll make it a little bigger. Something a little extra in the middle there. Oh, okay, wait. There. Let's see what it looks like. Just resimulate the foliage real quick on that, and good to go. This is just the conifer trees. And then the redwood trees. Let's keep this entirely pine needle a little stronger. Just so we have the trees spawning on that, because I feel like it's a little empty. Excuse me. Oh. Guess it just doesn't like spawning there. Alright, well. That's fine then. So you kinda get like a way up. A little more of an empty area. Could do something interesting down there. Neat. And what I'm gonna do is add a couple extra spawn points and maybe like one right here. Player starts out in the persistent level. It shall be. So there's one. Let's do another close to this, right here seems okay. And one by the river that the swampy area. Let's do it by that cave. Right here. And I'm gonna move this player spawn here. Find another one by where this water is. I think that'd be kind of cool. Then maybe one more by this road here. That's like six. All right. Let's save all this and commit it, and we'll be good to go. Thanks for watching, everyone. I'm gonna pop off now. See ya!